Today, to speak, as I was being asked, about European identity, that looks to me even a taller kind of a job. Because while Germany, after all, existed in one way or another, if not in a unified status for many hundreds of years, for many centuries, Europe, United Europe, only the integration process only started about two generations ago, and the European Union only exists even since about 20 years ago. And as we all know, the EU is neither a sovereign state, nor is it supposed to become one. That's due to the fact that the member states forming this union, presently they are 27, they are mostly opposed to making out of the EU a real state sovereign entity, since they believe that that would go too much to their detriment and at their expense. So, what's Europe, today's Europe, all about? What makes its identity? When we take a look first at the various member states of the EU and their history, we detect a certain common heritage, not based, certainly not on one language. We are all talking different languages. Not even much on a really common history, but on certain common cultural ties and ideas about the shape of our societies, ideas like Christianity, Enlightenment, liberalism, democracy, individualism, civil and human rights, all European ideas. But unfortunately also, there were European ideas on revolution or nationalism, authoritarianism and their, or its brutal excesses, on fascism, on Marxism-Leninism, on endless wars and civil strife, be it for reasons of religion or of hegemony. In other words, insofar as Europe has a common heritage, it represents a rather mixed blessing. Looking back on history as a European, or as Europeans, we find many reasons for being proud of our past and of ourselves, but also many that make us shudder and prefer to forget them, only to find out that in history there does not exist an easy way out from your past. In the aftermath of the French Revolution, Europe, supported by the struggle of liberation against Napoleon, Europe at that time created the nation state and with it the notion of national sovereignty. In the name of nationalism since then, many bloody wars were fought. Thanks to industrialization and growing ideological mobilization, these wars turned ever bloodier into crusades of good against evil. That was, of course, not only a European prerequisite, but was also valid